Hello viewers, welcome to the channel Globe Gemish.
The geographical location of Mangalore makes it easily accessible by all the major forms of transport, namely air, road, sea and rail. The man behind the construction and the springing up of Mangalore International Airport, New Mangalore Port and National Highway in Mangalore was U. Srinivas Mallya, a native individual of Mangalore and also member of the Indian Parliament. Ullal Srinivas Mallya is responsible for connecting Ullal and its surrounding areas with Mangalore. Statues of Mallya are found throughout the city of Mangalore. The transportation service in Mangalore is very well planned. Air transport in Mangalore. Mangalore International Airport is situated at Bajpe, which lies at a distance of 20 kilometers from the central point of the city. There is a new terminal that has started its operations from the mid of 2009 and it lies at a distance of 8 kilometers from the center of the city. Mangalore International Airport possesses various flights that help in connecting Mangalore to different destinations that are located at various places throughout the world. Emirates, SpiceJet, Jet Airways and Air India are some of the airline operators that operate at the Mangalore International Airport. Mangalore International Airport has grown and developed at present, and huge infrastructural development has also been found at the airport recently. Sea transport in Mangalore. Mangalore Harbour is also a major part of the transportation in Mangalore as it connects the city to different areas of the globe. Mangalore Harbour works in the form of a support for the transportation of fluid and bulk cargoes. In fact, it can be said that Mangalore Harbour serves as the doorway of Karnataka. The new Mangalore port serves as a station for Coast Guard and it is a modern and artificial harbour located at a distance of 10 kilometers north of Mangalore. The new Mangalore port at present is India's 9th largest port for handling cargo. Rail transport in Mangalore. In the past, Mangalore served as the very last station that helped in connecting Mangalore to various cities and the towns of India. The endeavor to connect Mangalore to Hassan by the way of a railway track running through the Western Ghats has failed. At present, there is a very wide gauge line that connects Mangalore to Bangalore through Hassan. The Southern Railway connects Mangalore to Chennai. When India got its independence in 1947, it was found that there were no trains that could connect Mangalore to Mumbai. The network of railway introduced between Mangalore and Mumbai was terminated before independence. It was due to the utter need of connecting Mangalore to Mumbai, the Konkan Railway was established. The project of establishing Konkan Railway concluded in the year 1998, and since that year, Mangalore is very well connected to the northern part of India and the time consumed to travel also has been minimized. Road transport in Mangalore. Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation runs the bus service in Mangalore, which largely supports the system of transportation in Mangalore. National Highway 27 is the national highway of Mangalore that connects the city to some of the most important towns and the cities in India. Four national highways are found passing through Mangalore and these highways connect Mangalore to various parts of the country. NH-17 is the national highway that runs through Panvel located in Maharashtra up to Edappally Junction located very close to Kochi in the state of Kerala. This national highway passes Mangalore in the north-south direction. NH-48 is the national highway that runs eastwards connecting the city to Bangalore, which is the capital of Karnataka, through NH-4. NH-13 runs in the northeast direction from Mangalore to a place called Solapur, and there is the state highway that connects Mangalore to Mysore city passing through Madikeri, which is a hill town. NH-234 is a 75 kilometers long highway connecting the city of Mangalore to Villupuram. The Mangalore, Ankola, Hubli, Belgaum, Pune, Mumbai is the longest bus route in Mangalore, and this bus route is widely used by KSRTC and private operators. The entire journey of this route is 22 hours by the use of normal buses and 16 hours if Volvo buses are used. Local transport for the public. The city bus service of Mangalore is very well operated by the private operators. Normally, there remain two specific set of bus routes where the routes of the city are covered by the city buses and the routes of the intercity are covered by the express and service buses. Auto rickshaw is another mode of local transport that can be used for moving around the city. The meter system of charging the customers is used by the drivers of auto rickshaws in Mangalore. However, the charges are not counted according to the meter in the time frame that ranges between 9 p.m. to 6 a.m.
Thank you, dear viewers, for watching this video. If you like this video, please press the like button, share the video with your friends, and subscribe for more videos.